As we have successfully configured Impala on our cluster using Cloudera Manager, now let us actually review components and properties of Impala. Impala have two master components. One is Impala State Store. Second one is Impala Catalog Server. And then one slave process, which is called as Impala Daemon. So this is how the Impala Daemon will look like. It will be there on all the worker nodes along with the data node, resource manager, node manager, etc. And Impala doesn't use Yarn for resource management or MapReduce or Spark for distributed processing. It has its own set of daemon process called Impala D, which will take care of resource management as well as the distributed processing of our data. And then at a master level, there is Impala State Store. All Impala daemons will actually communicate to Impala State Store, and Impala State Store will maintain the state of the Impala daemons in the cluster. Impala Catalog Server is the one which will communicate with Hive Metastore to actually interact with Hive Metastore, either to store metadata whenever a new table is created, or use that metadata to compile Impala query into a Impala job, which will be executed in the cluster. And this is how it actually looks like. You can see here, State Store and Catalog Store are considered as masters. And you can see that Impala D is on each and every worker node in the cluster. Impala D in turn have Query Planner, Query Coordinator, and Query Executor. These are the things which will actually take care of executing the query as Impala job in the cluster. You can also review the components by going into the Cloudera Manager. You can click on Impala here. You can review the components from this screen. You can see Impala Catalog Server, Impala State Store, and Impala Daemon. Impala Catalog Server is running on one host. Impala State Store is running on another host. Impala Daemon is running on three hosts. You can actually click on instances and see on which instance Impala Catalog Server and Impala State Store are running, and on what all instances Impala Daemon are running. So in this case, Impala State Store is running on Big Data Server 3. Impala Catalog Server is running on Big Data Server 4. And Impala Daemon is running on Big Data Server 5, 6, and 7. To review the properties, you can click on configuration and you can actually check some of the important properties here. You can see that as of now, Impala is using HDFS for file system. As there is no HBase, HBase is configured to be none. When it comes to resource management, on top of Impala, you can also actually plug in into the Yarn. So if you want to control Impala resource management as well using Yarn, you can do so by just choosing Yarn here. However, Impala is typically configured outside the Yarn in many cases, but if you want, you can use Yarn. That being said, there are not many properties which you need to break your head around at this time. As you gain experience, as you actually explore the tool in detail as part of the projects, you should be able to pick up more and more skills with respect to Impala. Now let us actually review the details from the command prompt. In this case, I am connecting to the gateway node first. And if you want to connect to the Impala shell, you have to connect through one of the nodes on which Impala D is running. So in this case, I can say Impala shell hyphen I, and then either Big Data Server 5 or 6 or 7. Let us choose Big Data Server hyphen 5 here, and you can see that it have launched Impala shell. The reason why we have to do it is, if you actually look at the architecture, you can see that Impala D in turn have Query Planner, Query Coordinator, and Query Executor. So it actually takes care of syntax and semantics checks of the query and convert the Impala query into the underlying job to execute. And it will be executed by Query Executor. As Query Planner and Query Coordinator are also part of Impala D, we have to use Impala D to actually connect through Impala shell or any other utility to connect into Impala cluster and run the queries. From here, you can run standard Hive commands like this, or you can actually run queries like this. Select count of one from order count by status, and it will actually submit the query and execute on the cluster. You can see that query is actually submitted on Big Data Server 5. However, it will coordinate with the others and it will try to execute if the job is big enough. Now I am coming out of this and first connecting to Big Data Server 3, where State Store is running. You can actually review the properties files by going into where run Cloudera SCM process or Cloudera SCM agent process, blah blah blah. The standard location, which is nothing but etc Impala cons, doesn't have any files here. Cloudera takes care of in its own way by creating the properties files under where run Cloudera SCM agent process, and you can run lsf and ltr here. One of the directories is Impala State Store. Let me get into the latest one here and then run lsf and ltr. You can see there are multiple properties or JSON files. All these are related to Impala only. So you can actually say view or cat Cloudera monitor.properties. You can see key value pairs separated by equal to as part of this Cloudera monitor properties. And then there are metrics properties also. It is kind of a JSON structure. So these are the actual properties. On top of this, it also have something called Impala conf directory here. You can see there is something called state store flags. You can actually review the details here. It is kind of setting the memory or port numbers, etc. So these are the three important properties files which Impala try to use to control the runtime behavior of the Impala related background process or daemon process. Even state store and catalog server are also daemon process, but they are master daemon process. Now, if you actually run ps-ef and then grep-i-impala, you can see that state store is running on this server. Also, you can actually review the logs by going to var log. So as any other service, the standard location for the log files is nothing but var log. There should be a directory on the name of Impala. You can see here. There is a directory called state store d here, which means state store daemon. However, there are no log files here. There is another directory which is named after state store here under var log directly. You can actually get into there and then run ls-ltr and you can see the log files here. If there are any issues with respect to state store and if you want to review the logs, you can come here and you can review this log file, which is nothing but state store d.error, and you can take it from there. As of now, there are not much logs generated. There are no issues with Impala here. That's why everything is a bit clean. You can also look into state store d info, and these are the logs that are generated as part of the info. So here they have categorized all the logs into three. One is info, second one is warning, and third one is error. If there are any errors, you should look into this file. If you just want to troubleshoot any issue, and if something is not available in error, then you should consider looking into info as well as warning. That being said, on top of Big Data Server 3 where we have state store d, now let us actually review the Big Data Server 4 where we have Impala catalog server. Again, you have to go to var run Cloudera SCM agent process and then run ls-ltr, and then you can actually review the properties related to Impala catalog server in this directory, and you can see the service metrics properties, Cloudera monitor properties, which we have seen on the state store server as well. On top of these things, you can also see the Impala configuration, Hive configuration, Hadoop configuration, because the catalog server requires the Hive Metastore details and also HDFS details to take care of certain tasks as part of the execution. That's why there is a dependency on Hive and Hadoop, and hence the properties related to Hive and Hadoop are also placed here. You can actually say ls-ltr conf and review the files that are available in each of these directories that ends with -conf. That being said, to troubleshoot the issues, you can go to var run, it is var log, and then run ls-ltr. You can see catalog d directory here, you can actually get into that and run ls-ltr, and you can see the warning info and error files for catalog d as well. Same is the case with Big Data Server 5 or 6 or 7 where Impala d is running. You can actually go to var run Cloudera SCM agent process and then 648 Impala d, and then you can actually review the properties files here. Even Impala d have dependency on HDFS as well as Hive, and hence you can see the directories for them here on top of service matrix properties, Cloudera monitor properties, and the file in Impala conf. Also, to troubleshoot the issues, you can actually go to var log, and then you see a directory called Impala d here. If you get into that Impala d directory, you should be able to see the warning info and error files for Impala d as well. So these are the files which you should look into to troubleshoot any issues. So these are the components, properties, and also the logs related to Impala. Very, very important to understand all these things so that you can actually troubleshoot the issues effectively whenever you run into some issues with respect to Impala. First, you need to understand the architecture. Then you should be able to get into the log files and also the properties files to troubleshoot any issues. On top of these things, Impala also have a web UI. You can click on this and you can either get into the state store web UI or catalog server web UI. However, we need to start shtetl for these URLs to work. So let me come out of this and then run shtetl from our PC to the gateway node of the cluster. Now you should be able to review the web UI a bit by refreshing this page. This is the state store D web UI. You can actually get the information of the cluster here and also the logs from here and many other things. For a period of time, you need to understand more about these things as you start supporting the Impala in the cluster. For now, to just set up and review, whatever is covered is enough. But once you actually start working in the project, you should be able to explore all these things in detail.